I go to the movies. And I was just by myself this time. I was not with a friend Ben. But it was fine. And it was a good time. And what did I see? I saw someone drop some bombs on the Fox News. Oh no! It was about the ladies and getting sexually harassed by the fat man. The dog that ails you or something. I don't remember that idiom. But that was played by the John Lithgow from Third Rock from the Sun, amongst other things. And he did a really good job, but they put him in this funny fat suit. And he looked weirder than he did whenever he was playing Churchill. But I thought he did a pretty good job. They kind of just gave him, like, weird speeches to give about how to be successful in the news business. And then he had some scenes where he was creepy. But the crazy thing about this was the ladies, they got to look like the famous ladies. It was like, that was amazing. They really looked like them. So, yeah, I remember when all this was going down. But, it was during the 2016, election cycle and all that. Whenever the Megyn Kelly, Trump got onto her case about, her, monthly times. Because she gave him hard questions at the debate. So, the movie kind of starts out with that sort of stuff going on. And, so it's basically, it's like, some really young lady, which I don't remember her story. Maybe it's based on a true part of it, or maybe it's a character they just made for this. Because she wasn't an on-air talent. And then, Gretchen, or whatever. But it was pretty interesting, because they had, you know, that Judge Jeanine, they had a character doing her, and they had a character doing Bill O'Reilly. And I don't know who the actor was there, but they put some prosthetic on his face. It looked just like him. But then, there was a guy that was playing Hannity. He didn't look anything like Hannity. There was a guy doing Geraldo, which is just basically a guy in a funny mustache. So, they had a couple scenes, that sort of thing. But it's, no. I yawned again. It was, mostly about, the Gretchen lady. She kind of gets the ball rolling. And then the Megyn Kelly, she's like, she doesn't know if she wants to get involved or not, even though something happened back in the day. Because she didn't know if anybody else would come forward. And that's what seems to be, like, a lot of this thing is, like, no one wants to say anything because they don't want to be the only one saying it. But once they figure out there's a whole bunch of people saying it, then they're like, oh, yeah. So, but yeah, so it's kind of a based on a true story thing. So, it's all public history. And it's kind of interesting kind of seeing the behind-the-scenes sort of stuff. That was kind of interesting, but like seeing kind of, they kind of do a layout of the building and like how, you know, where the newsrooms are and Roger Dale's floor and then, you know, the Murdoch's family's floor and all that sort of stuff. So it was kind of like, it was really kind of interesting. It's kind of like the way they're setting it up, like, the Murdochs, they were acting like the Murdochs didn't like Trump at all. But Ailes liked him or something like that. So there was, like, a little internal conflict kind of at the beginning. But then they just kind of were like, it was like, oh, well, Trump's obviously going to be the guy. So I guess we just got to get on board sort of thing. But it wasn't really too much about Trump. He's just kind of on the periphery of the movie. But I thought everybody did a really good job in the movie, acting wise. I mean, they weren't doing anything super artsy. There was a lot of fourth wall breaking where they just kind of look right at you. It's kind of like, oh. Or there'd be times when the Megyn Kelly character is like presenting like a 3D graphic of the building. And like I mentioned before, we're showing like where everything is and everything. I was like, well, that's really interesting how all that works out. But just seeing the inner office dynamics. Oh yeah, and that there's that one Saturday Night Live lady in there. I don't know if she's based on a real character or not. That's the thing. It's based on a true story, but outside of the Ailes and the Bill O'Reilly and, you know, all the famous people, I don't know if any of these other people are based on true people or not, or if they're just put in for the story, you know, for the tale they're telling. But I thought the movie was pretty interesting. I don't know if it's... Although the big part is... there was something where they were talking about people who came forward... That the guy harassed him before he worked at Fox News. And they showed their actual pictures. And I don't know if it was their voices or not saying what he did to him. But... It was like six ladies, I forget, but it'd show their picture, and then you'd hear what he did, and then it would kind of scroll over, and the other picture would come up, and these people weren't in characters in the movie at all. It was just like they took a little time out in the middle of this movie to just like, okay, these are real people, and he did awful things to these people. So, yep. What can you say? He obviously was an awful person who was abusing his power. That sort of thing. But unfortunately, with the human nature the way it is, whenever you give anyone too much power, they normally end up abusing it some way. But what you gonna do? So, Bombshell the movie. It was pretty interesting. I don't think it's necessarily a great movie. It was pretty cool that they made those actresses look like the news reporters. But, it was all right, you know. I guess really, it was just interesting. That's all I can really say. Bombshell the movie. It was interesting.